and videos, radio and TV shows, conferences, retreats and seminars. We got books and magazines to read on everything from A to Z, and a web to surf from anywhere we are. But I hope with all this information buzzing through our...
Hello and welcome to Worth More Than Rubies, wisdom for everyday life. My name is Cheryl Lacey Donovan, and today I have with me my co-host, Esther Renee Daniels, with Titus Two Words.
Hello, I'm glad to be here. Thank you so much for asking me.
You are
I really
so
appreciate
welcome.
It.
I'm so excited to have you with me today. And this month is November, and here in the United States, November is the month of Thanksgiving. So we decided that we would start the show this month talking about the things that we are grateful for. Mm-hmm. What about you, Esther? What are you grateful for?
Oh, I got a lot of things I could be grateful for. Since God has blessed me with the opportunity to have Titus Works, it has changed my whole life. Mm-hmm. I really have. And I've always wanted to feel like this adult. Mm-hmm. I feel like an adult. I feel like I'm doing something good in my life. And I'm really grateful for that.
Absolutely. You know, I think about the people that we work with in Kenya. Mm. And how grateful they seem to be with very little of anything. Yes. They are out there. They're praising the Lord. They're starting churches and doing just so many wonderful things. And I'm just excited about what's happening over there in Africa. And it makes me very thankful for all the things that I have.
Yes, I was just thinking this morning how, you know, we give so much credence to, to clothes and what we look like and the things we wear and how my hair looks and all of that kind of stuff. When in fact, there are people who barely have shoes to put on their feet. And, mm-hmm. and you know, your mom always tell you, if you don't do that, they're going to send you to Africa or whatever. But the thing is, today what I know is that all of that is not important.
Right.
And what is important is that I do what I believe God would have me to do to help another individual. And right here at home or wherever it may be, it doesn't matter. As long as they have what they need. Mm-hmm. And I love people who can be grateful for whatever it is, whether mm-hmm. how big or how small the gift is, mm-hmm. I really, really like doing for people who can see that the size of the gift is not what matters.
Absolutely.
It's what you do by giving it
Absolutely.
That matters.
And you know, that's a great segue that leads us into what our show is all about today. Mm-hmm. We are talking about blessed to be a blessing.
Yes.
And that comes from 2 Corinthians 9:11-12, mm-hmm. and then Colossians 3:17. So I'm going to go ahead and read that. Mm-hmm. 2 Corinthians 9:11-12 says, being enriched in everything to all bountifulness, which causes through us thanksgiving to God. Mm-hmm. For the administration of this service not only supplieth the want of the saints, but is abundant also by many thanksgivings unto God.
Yeah. You know what? And I like the version that I was doing. What I read was, it says, yes, you will be enriched in every way so that you can always be generous. And when you take your gifts to those who need them, they will thank God. Mm-hmm. And when I read that, I thought, they will thank God, mm-hmm. not me.
Not me.
And I think we talked about this earlier where I was talking about how many people don't think about, you know, the giving, what the receiver of my gift is mm-hmm. going to do is usually how I know God is going to be pleased with my giving.
Right.
But do we ever think about that person being thankful to God? I mean, I always want God to be pleased with what I do.
Right.
But I don't think we give with the thought of, if I give you this, Cheryl, I know you're going to praise God. Mm-hmm. It's usually, I know God's going to be pleased with me.
Right. Right.
And so I'm so grateful today to be able to read this and know that really my giving is not even about me.
It's not about me.
It's really not about me. It's truly about how that person may be reconnected or mm-hmm. their connection is increased mm-hmm. to God.
It goes back to motives. We talk about that all the time.
Yes.
What are your motives? And a lot of times, you know, and I really believe that's why a lot of the countries overseas kind of get upset with us here in the United States mm-hmm. because sometimes our motives are not pure enough. Sometimes, you know, our motives are about what's in it for me, what can I get out of it, how am I going to be, you know, lifted or elevated, or, you know, what are people going to think about me when I do these things? Mm-hmm. So it goes back to motives, and that's what the scripture speaks of, is that the bottom line is we are blessed to be a blessing to others so that other people will then in turn thank God mm-hmm. and see the glory of God and the gifts that we've been giving to them.
Yeah, and I also think that when we talk about motives, when you were talking, I was thinking about how people don't understand about works mm-hmm. and faith and being saved. I can do all kind of good stuff, but that don't mean I'm saved.
Right.
So absolutely. If I'm giving because I think God's going to be pleased to save me, mm-hmm. then I got a problem.
Right.
So if my motive is giving because I want God to be pleased with me and that person to be pleased with what God is doing right. in their life, right. then I'm not working to be in heaven. I'm mm-hmm. not working to get God's relationship. I'm doing it because that's what God would have me to do.
Absolutely. And, you know, that goes back to one of the commandments. It said, you know, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart mm-hmm. and with all thy mind and thy soul. And the second one is like unto it, love your neighbor yeah, as yourself. You yes. know, and on those two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Mm-hmm. If you're doing that, if you're doing it because, you know, this is just the love of God in me and this mm-hmm. is what I have been charged to do, mm-hmm. then it's a whole nother picture, a whole nother motive factor behind it. And I think sometimes we kind of forget that.
Yeah, I also think that what we don't remember is that we're mandated
yep,
to do it. We are mandated to give. Mm-hmm. That's what we're supposed to do.
We're supposed to do that.
Thanksgiving, when we talk about Thanksgiving, that should be the norm
right.
to me.
Right.
Thanksgiving, like my husband and I, we celebrate Christmas, but we believe that Christmas is every day.
Right. Exactly.
But
exactly.
Thanksgiving should be the norm. I shouldn't have to wait to November
exactly.
to be like thankful.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I shouldn't wait to November to be giving a turkey.
Mm-hmm.
I should be giving every day.
Yeah.
So whether it be in a physical gift mm-hmm. or just in a smile or a hug or a good morning,
yeah.
everything I do should be about giving.
Absolutely. And you know, in the kingdom, you know, I think that maybe we've kind of forgotten that a little bit. Because it seems like, you know, if I can't get accolades for what I'm doing, if I can't get a pat on my back, if I can't be the one that is the leader, if I'm not the president of the choir or the one that's actually organizing everything, then it can't be done, or it's not good, or it's not, you know, worthy of any of your efforts, because it's not about me. And I don't know, what do you think about that?
Well, you know, since Titus Works is my ministry, my baby, I really believe it's God's ministry who has allowed me to manage his ministry.
Mm-hmm.
It's not my ministry.
Exactly.
Okay, and so it's been in existence. It'll be a year on November 16th. Mm-hmm. And I have not done one call.
See?
I did one call because the person had to cancel at the last minute and I was shaking like a leaf. But I haven't done one call. And it's not because I just don't believe God has called me to do one call yet.
Mm-hmm.
And so when he's ready for me to do a call, he'll tell me. Right. It's time for you to do the call.
Right.
But if it was my baby, if it was my ministry,
right.
if it was my thing, then I would have been in there by 5-10 calls.
Exactly.
And nobody be
exactly.
saved.
Exactly.
So I'm real grateful to know that, you know what? Man, this is so time out for wanting to be seen. I just want God to know that I love him.
Absolutely.
I truly, you know, when the old folks used to say, I want God to say, oh, good, oh, good, my good and faithful servant, uh-huh. well done. I really understand that.
Yeah.
People don't believe me when I say I'll be 52 next week.
All right.
I'm so excited. But on this side of 50, I really understand how I want God to be pleased with me. Now, when I see him, I want him to say, well done,
right.
my good and faithful servant. Not well done, I know your motive wasn't quite right.
Yes,
I know you really was trying to get my attention. I'm not trying to get God's attention per se.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to get other people's attention to know that without him,
mm-hmm.
life is not what it should be.
And isn't that what we're called to do?
Yes.
That's what we're called to do. Let's look at Colossians 3 and 17. Mm-hmm. Colossians 3 and 17 says, and whatsoever ye do in word or deed,
mm-hmm.
do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God mm-hmm. and the Father by him. Mm-hmm. Everything that you do, I don't care how little it is,
mm-hmm.
I don't care how big it is, you know, I don't care. It all is done to the glory of God.
I was thinking about this, probably people may not, who don't watch this may not know, but I was watching Basketball Wives. Big show, right? And I, as a matter of fact, this morning I was thinking about it as I was backing out of my car, out of the driveway. And I said, you know, it's really sad because everything they do,
mm-hmm.
everything they say
right.
on this show is going across the country.
Across the country.
Across the nation.
Across the nation.
Yeah. So everywhere they go, people are going to be like, I don't want nobody to see me like that.
Absolutely.
Everything, I'm real concerned about my integrity, and I
right.
mean that from my heart.
Right.
When I say something to you, I want you to be able to say, yeah, Renee's going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to know that she means it from her heart.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want nobody walking away from me, I see it when I believe it.
You're right, right, right.
Well, I wonder what she going to want for that. I want you to be able to pick the phone up and call and say, I need you to do something for me and not be concerned that I wonder how much she's going to charge me to do that.
Wow, you know what? You hit the nail on the head. And I don't know, I know this is going to go out in a lot of places, but I'm going to go ahead and put it out there, and maybe some of those people can call me back and say, you know what? Not all of us are like that. Yeah. But it was real interesting that you said that, because sometimes I wonder, when you call on some of the people who are now celebrities, per se, in the gospel world or in gospel music, or, you know, preachers or ministers, whomever, and you want them to come to your local church and to do different things, you know, before they got that status, you know, they would come and they wouldn't mind it. You know, oh yeah, sure, I'll be there, no problem, just a love gift, love offering, whatever. But then they get to a certain level, and then all of a sudden it seems that it's no longer about God, but it's all about them and what they can get out of it.
Or it's a business.
Or, okay, well, you have to call my publicist, or you have to call my assistant and get this. And, well, you know, it's about that. Well, but, you know, where is God in all that? I thought that ultimately, particularly in the kingdom, now I understand the world will behave that way.
Yes.
I expect the world to behave that way. But where is God's glory in what you're doing
who
for the
kingdom? Who gave you the gift?
Exactly. Where is that? Yes. What happened to that? And you know, how can the world perceive you if that's what you're putting out there? You're behaving exactly like the world is.
Well, I think that, of course, I believe that they need to be paid.
Absolutely.
I think
Absolutely.
That they work hard for what
Absolutely.
They do. Their gift is awesome, and it takes a lot of practice.
Absolutely.
It takes a lot of time in putting all that together. So I get that. But I think that if someone is honest enough and humble enough to say to you, that my budget doesn't handle what your fees are.
Right.
Is there something we can do to make this happen? Mm-hmm. If they're humble enough to do that, I think you ought to do it.
Yeah.
That's just me.
Yeah.
I'm not making the kind of money they're making, so you know, I'm not
Absolutely.
Like that. I mean,
Absolutely.
I'm not there. So I'm saying that based on just a feeling. It's not anything that I'm factual about, but you know, I wish that it could be done that way.
Yeah. And I think that says a lot for, as you said earlier, integrity.
Mm-hmm.
And I agree. Absolutely, you should be, you know, paid for, you know, when you come out and you do different things and what have you. But I just believe that sometimes when, you know, when I pick up the phone and I call you and I tell you, you know, I really need you to come out and I need you to minister, you know, to this particular group or whatever, that your first concern should not be, well, how much money do you have?
Yeah.
You know, what is your budget?
Yeah.
You know, what can you, that just really should not be the first concern.
Yeah. Because I'm telling you, my actions says a lot about me.
Absolutely.
Before I even open my mouth. Is what I do. A friend of mine told me this one time. This was about when I was on my way to being saved.
Okay. I've been there, done that.
And I was thought I was in love. And,
right.
And this person told me they were gonna do something, and they didn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just devastated. I was like, oh my God! They told me they were gonna do it. I can't believe they didn't do it. And so she said to me, she said, Renee, a person can talk to you till they blue in the face,
mm-hmm.
but what do their feet show you?
Wow.
And I thought, what if he got to do? And so later on I realized that I could talk to you all day long about what I say I'm going to do.
Right.
But if my feet and my words don't match,
right.
something's wrong with that picture.
Right.
And so I just believe that my words and my feet need to match.
Because
if I say something, but I'm doing something different, something is wrong with that picture.
Yeah.
And so when I talk about integrity and I don't want... I'm not doing it so you can like me.
Right.
Okay? I want you to know that. I really don't care about that. I ain't gonna say I don't care. I do care. But what I most care about is what is God gonna say?
Yeah.
When I lay my head down at night, can I honestly lay down and think, okay, I did that wrong, but I might want to fix that.
Right.
Or even more so say, how was my day? What did I do today? Okay. I'm okay.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do that
mm-hmm.
more so than not.
Yeah.
So I'm not perfect. I make mistakes.
Absolutely. We all do.
But I do. My desire is that my words match what I do.
Yeah.
So yeah, that Colossians 3:17 says that whatever you do or say, do it as a representative of the Lord Jesus.
Right.
So that means I'm in the grocery store. I shouldn't be cutting the folks up.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
That means I need to figure out how can I work some patience in here somewhere.
Right.
I know I'm in a long line. The lady moving slow. She might have backache. I don't know.
You don't know. You don't know.
But I need to remember that who I'm representing
mm-hmm.
is not me. Wherever I am, I'm representing God.
Absolutely. You know, that brings me to this point, too. I've heard people say all the time, sometimes the only Bible people will ever read is you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they might not even pick up a Bible, but you run around saying that you're a Christian and you love God, and then they look at you and your life is raggedy, or the way that you're living is raggedy, or, you know, they cut you off in line, and the first thing you do is cuss at them, or, you know, point the finger at them, or, you know, whatever the case may be. And that is so important, because we have to remember who it is that we're representing.
Yeah.
And sometimes that's, you know, sometimes it's difficult. You know, I know even on your job sometimes people get in your face and get on your nerves and do things that are not right. But,
you know, but sure, when I think about that, if people are so quick to say, oh, man, she's supposed to be a Christian.
Right.
Well, I am. And that, but what we need to remember, too, is that we're human first.
Yes.
And God knew we were going to make some mistakes.
Absolutely.
So if I happen to kind of lose it a little bit, then the Christian thing for me to do is to realize that my actions were not right.
Yeah.
And come back to you
and
say, you know what? That wasn't right.
Yes.
And then I still meet what Colossians 3:17
Absolutely.
Says.
Absolutely.
Because Jesus turned over tables.
Yeah, okay.
Mad because they weren't doing
they
it right.
They weren't doing the right thing.
So he got angry. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to get angry. Uh-huh. But it's what I do after that that's going to make the big difference.
Be angry and don't see it. Be angry and don't sin. And the Christian thing that the other person will do is to forgive you.
That's right.
Is to forgive you. Sometimes it doesn't happen always in the body of Christ, but it is what it is. And you know, it's just amazing, these two passages of scriptures, and thinking about being blessed to be a blessing, and, you know, Thanksgiving coming up, and being thankful to God for all of the things that he's done for us. You know, I'm thankful even to be able to be sitting here with you, and that we have a kingdom connection, right? With Titus. Tell me a little bit about Titus 2 Works.
Well, Titus is a ministry that I really, really believe God delivered to me, because a friend of mine who had breast cancer had passed away, and when she passed, they asked if I would come speak at her funeral. And when studying for that funeral, I went to Titus. God led me to Titus chapter 2, and it talks about giving back to the young and helping them to find, for me to model goodness so that they could live the life that God ordained for them to live. And in thinking about my relationship with her, that's exactly what she did for me. When she created my lab scarves, and I would go to Beaumont, because that's where I'm from, Beaumont, Texas.
Okay.
Yeah. Go try. And I'd go to Beaumont to see her and buy my lab scarves. And when I'd go, she'd have tea cakes waiting for me.
Wow.
With some coffee, and we'd sit down and eat tea cakes and eat some little bitty potato pies.
Good stuff.
Anyway, so I'd go have this time with her, and she would share some things with me, and I would be able to ask questions that I wouldn't be able to stand up in Bible study and ask.
Right.
So she'd share these things with me, and man, I realized that she was my Titus friend. Mm-hmm. And God gave me this idea that how many people are sitting across the world today who don't have these kind of relationships, who don't have somebody that they can call and ask the kind of questions they need to ask. Yes. And so he said, I think you need to do something with that. Mm-hmm. And I was talking to a friend of mine who's a young adult and who I mentor, and she gave me the word Titus Works. It works. Yeah. And I said, ooh, that's good.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
And so we thought about doing a conference call that would allow people to be able to call in and ask those questions on a particular topic. And I remember the first call we did, we talked about being a Titus Works person and letting people mentor you. And so somebody called in and they asked this question. My mate and I decided that we're going to live together, but we are being abstinent.
Okay.
And she said, is that still shacking?
Wow.
Now you know she ain't gonna stand up in church and ask that
question. No, she's not gonna ask that question in church.
Right. So of course we said, yeah, baby. That's still shacking.
But my point was the platform was for her to ask the question. And that's what Titus Works does.
Yeah.
So I love it, and I'm just so grateful that God has blessed me with the opportunity to be a part of that, and to watch people call in and really interested in what we talk about. And so we talk about a lot of things. It's not all just straight biblical. We talked about how do we protect our children from social media. We talk about a lot of different subjects, and so it's been a real blessing.
That is awesome. Well, look, before you get ready to give them the information about Titus Works, I just want to kind of piggyback on what you said, because one of the things you said was that we don't, in church, there's not a forum for them or a platform to be able to do that. That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
That is really unfortunate, because that really is supposed to be the place that we should be able to go to and talk about that kind of stuff.
Well, I think that what has happened is that the young adults are feeling like they're left.
Yeah.
There's nothing there for them.
Yeah.
And to ask those kind of questions brings about a lot of shame and guilt because it's as if they're supposed to know. Mm-hmm. Well, how are they supposed to know?
If nobody teaches them.
So I know that it's easier to ask the question over the phone than it is to ask the question in the standing in
person,
front of people.
Right.
Because of the shame and guilt that's placed on them.
Nobody can see me, so.
Yeah. So that's why it's successful. I really believe that God has placed that there so that they won't go in the dark doing things that they know they feel is wrong.
Right.
But it sure feels better when somebody is validating what you know you is wrong.
Absolutely.
That no, you shouldn't do that. And that gives you some conviction.
Yeah.
And some accountability. So yeah.
Okay.
So if people want to call in,
right,
it happens every first and third Thursday at 8 p.m. Central Time. The number is area code 424-203-8000 and the access number is 179-775. I think about that. 179-775.
Remember now, I'll say it a little slower. Yeah. People trying to write it down.
Okay, well just go to the website. Okay. www.titus2empower.com.
Okay.
Titus2empower.com.
Great. Esther, thank you so much. It has been so great. This has been Worth More Than Rubies, Wisdom for Everyday Life, and I've been your host, Cheryl Lacey Donovan, here with Esther Renee Daniels from Titus Two Works. We're glad that you joined us today. You can find out more information about Worth More Than Rubies at www.worthmorethanrubiesministries.org. That's www.worthmorethanrubiesministries.org. We'd also like to invite you to come out for our fellowships at the Spring Hill Suites Marriott if you're here in the Houston, Texas area. That's at 1400 OST, Houston, Texas, 77054. And remember, God can do exceedingly and abundantly more than you could ever ask or think, according to the power that lies within you. Be blessed.
You are pregnant with purpose and pregnant with greatness. Don't allow the enemy to cause you to abort the vision. God has a big life for you, one that has peace, joy, and wholeness. His plan includes love and value, purpose and fulfillment, provision and supply, but you can't get to the upper level when you're stuck on the ground floor.
Take me a little ride back down memory lane, past the verbal and the physical abuse and all the trauma and the pain. I've got to flee from this crazy situation, 'cause it's driving me insane. Now I'm packing up all of my broken pieces and the little bit of strength that remains.
got CDs, tapes, and videos, radio and TV shows, conferences, retreats, and seminars. We got books and magazines to read on everything from A to Z and a web to search.